حور العين تناديني فدعيني أماه دعيني، حور العين تناديني فدعيني أماه دعيني. لا تبكي دموعك يا أمي عند دربي لا لن تثنيني، لا تبكي دموعك يا أمي عند دربي لا لن تثنيني عند دربي لا.
بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعوا بإحسان لدين. Respectable brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Keep smiling. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all beautifully. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us and all of you al-Jannah. Firdaus ya arhamar rahimin. Today, inshallah, we're going to look at another topic as well, bi'idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But before that, as I always say, please don't forget to subscribe or click the button of our subscription, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from you. Our topic today is about one of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me take you to the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Baqarah, He said, وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفًا. And remember when your Lord said, I am going to create a being representative who is going to live on earth, inherit this land. قَالُوا, and the angels, they said in response to that, Oh Allah, أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءِ. Allah, are you going to create a being or someone or something that is going to spread mischief on earth and spill blood? قال, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded, He said, إِنِّي أَعْلَمْ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. I know what you knew not. I know what you do not know. Eventually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam alayhi salam, our father, Allah created him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the angels, instructed them to prostrate, to bow down to Adam alayhi salam. He said, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمْ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. And remember when I said to the angels, I said, bow down to Adam alayhi salam as a respect and honor for the being that I have created. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they all did as they were told or commanded, except Iblis. He is not an angel. So he said, Abba, first of all, he denied. He disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He refused to do so, to bow down to Adam. And Allah said, was takbara. And he became arrogant, pomposity. وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. And as a result, he became amongst the unbelievers. Another ayah, it said, Allah, I will not bow down to him. Why? When Allah asked him, why? He said, خَلَقْتَنِي مِن نَار. Because he gave, talk about himself first. He said, خَلَقْتَنِي مِن نَار وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِن تِين. You created me from fire, smokeless fire. And you created him from dust, thing, dirt. You cannot compare two of them. So that's what he was trying to demonstrate, saying, I am better than him. But this is one of our problems. We think we are better than others just because of our possession, just because of our positions, just because of our status. What we have makes us think that we are better than others. You're not. You're not. Brothers and sisters, you are not. Iblis, two things. He was arrogant and he disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as a result, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed him from his mercy. He removed him completely from his own mercy. Allahu Akbar. Do you want to be one of them? As I said, you're not better than the other person. Whether you're black, you're white, you're dark, you're short, you're tall, you're not better than the other person except by piety. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. He said, Ya ayyuha an-nas, He said, O you mankind, إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى. Surely I have created you, us males and female. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلًا لِتَعَارَفُوا. And I have put you into tribes and nations so that you may know each other. But إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. The most honored one amongst you, the one who is honorable, the one who is the king to Allah, is the one who is more God conscious, the one who has more piety than all of us. رُبَّ عَارِيَةٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا كَاسِيَةٌ فِي الْآخِرَةِ رُبَّ كَاسِيَةٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا عَارِيَةٌ فِي الْآخِرَةِ. The Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, maybe the person, the one you see well dressed, beautifully dressed in the dunya, is naked يوم القيامة. Maybe the one who is naked, you see him like he has nothing, he is well dressed and honored in the sight of Allah يوم القيامة. So you don't know. Put yourself down. Humble yourself. من تواضع لله. Whosoever humbled himself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala رفعه الله. Allah will raise them above. He will raise their position. When you humble yourself, Allah will raise you up. Be amongst those humble servants. That's why the Rasulullah said, he said, Allah said in the hadith Qudsi, this is on the authority of Imam Ahmed, Abu Dawood, Ibn Majah. He said that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, according to his Lord, Allah said, Hadith Qudsi, he said, Al-Kibriya. He was reported about his Lord. He said, Allah said, Al-Kibriya. He said, pride, arrogance, pride. Ridai is my cloak. My cloak. Pride is my cloak. And he continued saying, Wala adamatu. Might, majesty, is izari. Put it this way, is my wrapper, my garment. فَمَنْ نَازَعْنِ فِي شَيْءٍ مِّنُهُ أَدْخَلْتُهُ فِي النَّارِ. He said, whosoever contend with me, whosoever competes with me, Allah, in respect to these two, pride and might, he said, I will definitely throw him into the fire without even paying attention. Put yourself down, brother. We like saying, Anna, I am my client, I am better. No, you're not. You're not, brother. You're created min turab. Look how Allah created Adam, our father, from dust, clay, dirt. And myself and you, semen, sperm, it came from our dirt, backbone, and went into our mother's womb. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved you, transformed you from one stage to another until you become who you are today. You were nothing and you became something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينُ مِنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. Have you got the news that you were nowhere to be found? Nowhere to be mentioned. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you. إِنَّا خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ أَمْشَاجٍ نَبْتَلِيهِ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا. From sperm, worthless, put it that way. And he gave you eyesight, everything. And he became who you are today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored you. So therefore, with arrogance, you will not be able to achieve this dunya and the hereafter. Never. It is also narrated, it has also been narrated on the authority of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. He said that the Messenger of Allah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah, he said, none shall enter the hellfire. None of you will enter the hellfire. من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من الإيمان. He said, whosoever has in his heart a weight of a mustard seed of iman, even this, even if that weight, the size of iman, is as a mustard seed, right? If he has that kind of level, that kind of size of iman in his heart, he will enter Al-Jannah. As long as he does not commit shirk. Allahu Akbar. May Allah make us be amongst the dwellers of Al-Jannah. I repeat, on the authority of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يدخل النار. He shall not, or none shall enter the hellfire. من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة أو خردل من الإيمان. He said, he who has the size of Iman, right? Equivalent to that of the seed of a mustard. If they have that size of Iman in their hearts, they will not enter the hellfire. And he continues saying, he said, and none shall enter. لا يدخل الجنة. He or she or none shall enter Al-Jannah, paradise. من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة أو مثقال خردل من الكبر. He said, he or she or none shall enter paradise. He who has in his heart the weight of a mustard of seed of pride will not enter the Al-Jannah. Subhanaka ya Rabb. So humble yourself. Why the arrogance? Why me? Why I? No. Whatsoever knowledge you possess, whatsoever position you have, whatsoever possessions you have, wallahi, you're nothing. Except if you're a God-fearing person. And as well, you have to humble yourself. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam was humble. He's your role model. Look at the way we're going to die. Right now I'm sitting here. The day we're going to die, they will lay you down on the floor. They wash your body. A place which is not better to you, right? Than what you used to have, the bed, posh bed, you lie down there. They're gonna carry you one day on the shoulders. And your bed, where you're going to lay down. Right? They're going to lay you down in that bed, would be your grave, waiting for the day of resurrection. Your pillow would be dirt. Your bed sheets would be dirt. Your duvet would be dirt. Everything, your cover, right? Everything would be dirt. Because you are dirt. You are created from dirt. So this should be a lesson to myself and you all. Don't say my tribe, your tribe. Now, we don't talk about tribe in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid us, right, from being tribalistic. This ism. Abstain from it. Be yourself and humble yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise you above, will lift you above. Right? These names, honorable, doctors and etc. make some of us become so arrogant and proud. Don't do that. Allah said, وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَّحَا إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَخْرِقَ الْأَرْضِ وَلَنْ تَبْلُغَ الْجِبَالَ طُولًا. Don't walk on the surface of this earth arrogantly. By doing so, you will not be able to dig the earth, nor will you be taller than the mountain. وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا. The humble, the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the special servants of Allah, when they walk on the surface of this earth, they walk with humility. They are humble. They are humble. So if you want to be amongst the dwellers of Al-Jannah, you don't want to be prevented to enter the Al-Jannah and being admitted in the hellfire, then change your ways. Put yourself down. Your color does not matter. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرَ إِلَى سُوَرِكُمْ. Allah does not look at your pictures, your forms, your alwan. No, it doesn't look at. It doesn't look at how huge you are, how wealthy you are. وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرَ إِلَى قُلُوبِكُمْ وَعَمَالِكُمْ. Allah looks at your heart and your deeds, your actions. The actions. لَا أَفْدَلِيَ. There is no superiority over black or white or short or tall or wealthy or rich in Islam. We are all equal. كَأَسْنَانِ الْمُشْتِ. Like the teeth of a comb, we are all equal. That's why when you stand on the sofa, We all stand together. The one who comes first occupies the first line. It does not matter if the president comes last. We don't take that. We don't, you know, Islam does not say not because the president comes last to the mosque, he should go to the front line. No. Who comes first, go to the first line to tell you that we are equal. We are equal. Please, if you have any of these, some of us, we even refuse others to marry our own tribes because they are not from our tribes, because they are not from my country, they are not from my clan, they are not from this and that. Ya akhi, Adam alayhi salam, where was he from? Hawa, our mother, how many women were there, the wives of Adam? Only one woman Allah created. Then Allah created Adam and he created Hawa. From there as well, all of us come from with different alwan, ikhtilaf. Alwan wal alsun, different colors, different tongues, different dialects, so that we may know each other. We may know each other. But the best amongst you are those who are God conscious. So please, let this be a lesson for myself and you all. And remember the day you're going to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're nothing except if you make it worth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it worth for all of us. Keep smiling. Jazakumullahu anna khair al-jazak. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you and reward each and every one of us. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
حور العين تناديني فدعيني أمه دعيني. حور العين تناديني فدعيني أمه دعيني. لا تبكي دموعك يا أمي عند